Thank you, Mr. Chair. Mr. Lewandowski, earlier in your testimony, you questioned the love that Democrats have for our country. I served on active duty in the United States military. Do not question my love of our country. I'm not going to question yours. We are all Americans. Now, earlier in your testimony, you had made a pretty stunning concession, which is that you had not read the Mueller report. That explains a lot about your testimony, and I'm thinking maybe you don't know what the special counsel actually found. So I'm going to tell you. Volume 1 of the Mueller report found that the Russians attacked American elections in a sweeping and systematic manner. It also found that the Trump campaign knew about the attack, that they gave internal polling data to the Russians, that they planned their campaign strategy around this attack. It's not just in the Mueller report, it's also in Robert Mueller's testimony under oath in front of the Intel Committee, as well as this committee. The reason we are here today is because Volume 2 finds that the president tried to obstruct that investigation into the Russian attack on at least 10 instances, 5 of which Robert Mueller found there was substantial evidence. So I'm gonna put up a slide about what the special counsel found about this particular incident in which you're involved. He found substantial evidence that the president's effort to have sessions limit the scope of the special counsel's investigation to future election interference was intended to prevent further investigative scrutiny of the president's and his campaign's conduct. So that's why we're all here today. And I think it's important to look at the timeline to understand how this all unfolded. You previously testified that in March 2017, that you were aware that Attorney General Sessions recused himself. He did that in March 2017. I'm gonna put up a slide about what the White House Counsel's Office had directed about communications with Sessions. It said that Sessions should not be contacted, no contact with Sessions, and no serious concerns about that instruction. Did you ever get that instruction from anyone not to contact Sessions at all?
Clock is
stopped. No.
Okay, thank you. A few months later, on June 14, 2017, the media reports that the obstruction investigation, well, actually, that the Russian investigation turns into obstruction investigation into the president himself. And then when Donald Trump learns about this, he goes nuts. Isn't that correct?
I don't know that to be accurate.
The president launched over 10 tweets very shortly thereafter calling the investigation a witch hunt. That's correct, isn't it?
I don't know that to be accurate.
He did. All right, so then he calls Don McGahn at home and says that Mueller has to go, call me back when you do it. Were you aware of that he called Don McGahn at home to tell him to fire Mueller?
No.
Okay. 2 days after that phone call, the president calls you into his office. You admitted that he dictated a message for you to carry to Jeff Sessions. You said that you didn't give it to Jeff Sessions because you went on vacation. The Mueller report actually says that the Attorney General canceled that meeting. That's correct, isn't it? The Attorney General, in fact, canceled the meeting that you tried to give the note to?
Where is that reference in the report, Congressman?
Sure, it's on page 92. I'm gonna give you the courtesy, I'm just gonna read it for you. It says, Lewandowski called Sessions and arranged a meeting for the following evening at Lewandowski's office, but Sessions had to cancel due to a last minute conflict. You do remember that?
I believe that's accurate.
Okay, all right. And then a little bit later on July 8th, the media writes additional negative information about the president and his campaign, including that his senior advisors and his son met with Russian operatives who had dirt on Hillary Clinton as part of Russia and its government's support for Mr. Trump. Donald Trump then calls you back into his office again, alone, for a meeting. And this time, he tells you that Sessions is going to be fired if he doesn't meet with you. Do you recall that conversation?
I took that as a joke.
Okay, you took that as a joke. After that, the president goes on TV and he says, Sessions should have never recused himself, and if he was going to recuse himself, he should have told me before he took the job and I would have picked somebody else. Do you think the president was joking when he said that on TV?
I don't know if the president was joking or not.
When the president met with you alone to ask if you delivered the note to Sessions, do you believe any of that was a joke?
I can't discuss a private conversation with the president that isn't in the report, sir.
Okay. yield back.